MSTC Limited, a Government of India Enterprises, the IPO recently hit the markets, and today the company has gotten listed. We have the management of MSTC Limited, Mr. B.B. Singh, who is the Chairman and Managing Director at MSTC. He'll be speaking about the growth prospects of the company moving forward. Mr. Singh, thank you so much for speaking to Bloomberg Quint. If you could just take us through the overall prospects for MSTC with respect to the e-commerce business, and how do you really plan to monetize your virtual monopoly in the segment of auctioning government blocks as well as mineral blocks?
Thank you very much. E-commerce has been the mainstay of MSTC Limited. This segment we have diversified into many other things. We started with the auction of scrap, but thereafter we have added too many commodities into our kitty, and there has been exponential growth in e-commerce since last 9-10 years. I think the growth has multiplied by almost 11 times in last 10 years. So this is a very upcoming business segments for MSTC Limited, and it will continue to grow because we have not tapped the potential what is there in the market in e-commerce sector. So we hope that with our expertise and our endeavor, we'll be able to achieve greater milestones in e-commerce business.
Okay. Mr. Singh, talking specifically about e-auctions, yes, yes. Last time when you met us in the studios, you specifically mentioned the fact that there are a lot of mines also which will be auctioned. A lot of commodities also are likely to be auctioned, and your platform probably would be that one thing that everybody would be looking forward to. So if you could tell us, in the near term, in the medium term, do you think all of these auctions upcoming, auctions especially from state governments will probably add significantly to your revenues and profits?
Yes, in 2014, when Honorable Supreme Court has entrusted MSTC for conduct of the e-auction for coal blocks which were deallocated. So that was the time when we started our business in for the auction of mineral blocks. If you talk about non-coal mineral blocks, the Ministry of Mines, Government of India has nominated MSTC for conducting auctions for the major mineral blocks as well as for minor mineral blocks. Ever since the MMRD Act has come into being in 2015, we have been conducting regular mineral blocks for major minerals on behalf of the states. This segment is going to grow exponentially in the days to come because there are umpteen number of major and minor mineral blocks which are slated to be sold through e-auctions platform. So we foresee a very huge business opportunity in mineral sectors. As far as minerals are concerned, be it lignite, barite, chromite ore, manganese, iron ore, all the minerals are getting sold through the e-auction platform of MSTC. So going forward, we foresee a huge business opportunity in mineral sector itself.
Okay. Mr. Singh, you earlier also said that you were in the business of steel trading. You had to take a couple of write-offs as far as certain steel deliveries were concerned because it turned bad. How do you really see your business model evolving? Do you think your commodity trading business is something which you will probably scale down moving forward, and how really do you see write-offs happening as far as steel stocks are concerned, which are still lying with you?
We had exposure in steel sectors and the petroleum sectors. As you know, that steel sector has not been performing well for the last couple of years. So our all the exposures in the steel sector has turned bad, and because of the SEBI compliances and also the audit qualifications, we had to provide for all the doubtful trade receivables, and we have cleaned our balance sheets. We don't say that those are not all collectible. Majority of them will be collectible in the days to come.
And when it comes to the trading side of the business, are you hopeful that you will be able to scale down on this particular business segment and focus on the e-commerce business, wherein you see much more growth and opportunities happening?
See, earlier the trading business was 80% of the total value of merchandise. And these days the trend has reversed. The e-commerce volume of merchandise is 80% and 20% is the trading. The cash and carry model, what has gone wrong for our business? Now we are going to replace this cash and carry model by 110% BG backed business, which is risk free. And we have also associate model for procurement, which is risk-free. So we are promoting these two business verticals in trading segment. But of course, we are focusing more on e-commerce than the trading business. And as I told you that we are adding a lot many commodities into our kitty for e-commerce. So this e-commerce will witness a huge spurt in business in the days to come.
Sir, talking about the financial performance from here on, what is the kind of growth levels that you see coming in for MSTC? And if you could tell us exactly what is the kind of EBITDA margin profile would you like to maintain, just for the benefit of our investors and, you know, viewers, what would be your, growth trajectory on that front?
As far as our operating business is concerned, we have been doing very well, but because of the provisioning, we had to incur a loss. We had to show the incurrence of loss in our balance sheets. Now we have cleaned our balance sheets, so in future we don't see such provisioning in the days to come, and the e-commerce business will prop up our, both top line, bottom line, to a greater extent. So we see that there should be a good both top line and bottom line growth for the company.
Okay, and we wish you all the very best, Mr. Singh, for the future endeavors and the growth with relating to your e-commerce business. So that was the management of...
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah. So that was the management of MSTC talking about really how do they see opportunities from the e-commerce segment, especially when it comes to the e-auction of mineral blocks and the produce of such minerals.